It has been the greatest honor to be here at the school. It has been a journey that has really helped me understand how rooted the school is to the history and to the community of Dade City. The children here come every day just wanting to learn, and my staff comes here every day just to nurture them and feed them that hope for a future and the skills that they need to be successful in their future.
It's like a root foundation for Dade City. It's a blessing to the community. The community and the school work together very well. And I just think that without it in our community, we'd be a little lost.
Cox is like a family. It's a family environment. The teachers we're always together, and we know that we're here to do what's best for kids. And that's one of the reasons why we stay here.
I was born in 20, started a school in the first grade in 26 at a little wooden bungalow behind the old high school. After the Christmas holidays of 26, returned to school here. This school then opened in January of 27. I had a teacher, Myrtle Hunt, who was my sister in the first grade, and I had another sister, Esme Blitch, who was my teacher in the second grade. Patty DeBall was a classmate. Her mother, Mrs. DeBall, was my home run teacher in the fifth grade. And I can't spell it, but in the sixth grade, my home run teacher was Sally Hieronymus.
As a student, I just have fond memories of the things that happened to me, from the teachers I had in school to being out on the playground. We weren't supervised on the playground at all back then. It was a different time. And the teacher used to sit in a folding chair near the school and just watching the playground. But we had no supervision and there were no problems.
I actually was a student here myself when Rodney B. Cox was the principal. I believe that was in 1968. I remember clearly the staff that was here during that time. My first grade teacher's name was Verna Ross. I remember everything about her till today, the way she looked, the way she walked. Leonard Simador, Chuck Lease, Gene Johnson, Louis Frejo. I mean, those were the years.
I came here for the third grade through the fifth grade, so I'm very connected to this school. And I remember so many things, you know, having a connection with the teachers. I remember teachers coming to my home. I remember the dance contest, the spelling bees. I remember sitting under the shade tree with the teacher one-on-one. I'll never forget that teacher. And they just believed in me. It's just always, you know, pat you on the back and said, be somebody.
I was a student at Dade City Grammar School. I started first grade in 1948. My mother taught here. Her name was Carolyn Dudley, and she would just happen by when I was in a desk outside the room. So that was not very pleasant, but I just learned to have to live with it.
I only got whippings three times. First grade as a teacher, a sister, second grade a teacher, and the fifth grade in Mrs. DeBall's class, a classmate passed a shady note to me and I didn't even get to open it and read it. But they called both of us down to the principal's office and he went first and he came back and told me if I held my breath when he hit me, it wouldn't hurt so much.
I came to Cox in about 1981 and I worked here at Cox until I retired in 2014. So approximately 35 years, I worked at Cox.
I really remember one teacher for the most, Ms. Nicholson. I'm not sure if she's still here, but she was very adamant about us reading.
It was a wonderful, wonderful experience. For all the years that I was here, the teachers and the kids and the community, we were like a family. We were always there for each other.
It's like a giant hand reaching out to the community. It's very invested in the community. We see the children as you know, people who have potential. We see their, you know, hopes and dreams. We dream into our children. That's what I feel like.
I love this place. There was a very small amount of time in my life that I've not been here. It has been a joy. I can't even put into words, and I'm not one to not be able to do that. But the children, the parents, the staff.
I can't imagine working for Pasco County Schools and not being at Cox Elementary School. I have to tell you, every morning when I drive down that cobblestone street and I look at that beautiful old building, it just warms the cockles of my heart.
I've always admired the school and the way it looked. It's different from any other school in Pasco County.
Because it tells just how long it's been here, the strongness, the strength in the building, the walls, and that strength leaves the walls and go into each and every one that works there.
The outside of the building reflects what goes on the inside. There are kids that have been here, actually teachers and families that have been here for years that kind of just, it's about the history of Pasco County or Dade City, basically. Their fathers and their sons have gone, their children go here, their fathers went here. There's just a lot of history here in this building.
Well, I wanted him to, you know, walk my footsteps and just do it better. That's all you want for your kids. And I knew that he can do that here. I knew that there was people that cared about me and they were still here teaching, and I knew they would care about him just as much to know that you're doing good. Now let's continue on. Let me help the next generation. And I knew I would only get that here.
We have the best kids ever at Cox Elementary. Our kids are amazing. They come from various backgrounds and they have all sorts of strengths that they bring to school with them every single day. And we have this amazing faculty that knows how to find those strengths for each student and just keep building upon them and building upon them.
Coming in every day and telling kids and believing in kids and giving them that hope for a future is really what we strive for.